Hello everyone and welcome back to another video by Simplilearn. This is Anubhav and in this video, we are going to create a portfolio website using React.js. But before we begin, if you haven't subscribed to our channel already, make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you will never miss any update from Simplilearn. So without further ado, let's begin and see what's in it for you. But before we jump to the coding part, let me tell you what React is. So, what is React.js? React is a JavaScript library that is used to build mobile and web applications. It is fast and interactive. React.js is an open source, reusable component-based front-end library of JavaScript. React is a combination of HTML and JavaScript. It provides a robust and opinionated way to build modern applications. So, let's jump to the coding part and see what we are going to create. So, before we jump, let's open our terminal to install some commands. Here, I have already created my React project. You can also create a React project. It is very simple. Just type a command npx create React app and then the folder name. In my case, it's and just enter it, it will create a portfolio app for you. So, I have already created, so I'm not gonna enter this. So, let's cut this. After that, let's begin with our code. What you have to do is write a command npm react install first, install react. Router DOM and then press enter. It will install React Router DOM in your system. But before install this command, you must have installed npm in your system. So let's move forward and enter. I have already installed this command, but just to tell you guys, I'm entering. Okay, meanwhile, it'll take a couple of seconds. Meanwhile, I'm going to create a folder inside this source. And let's name this folder. And let's clear this terminal. Now, what we'll install is Material UI icons. So for that, the command is npm install add material slash icon. You will press enter and it will take a couple of seconds again more to install this command. I have already installed these commands in my system. Just to clear you guys, I'm installing them again. So let's start our development process. Inside this, okay. Now let's open this app.js. Inside this, I'm going to import React. After that, I'm going to import the CSS file of this app.css import dot app dot scss. Okay, now let's close this. After that, let's create a function app. Inside this, let's return if class name app. After that, let's close this. Yeah, okay, fine. part is to export this file. So I'm going to write export default app. Let's save it. Now let's again open the terminal by just pressing Ctrl plus backtick, or you can just go here and just type new terminal. Here we'll write npm start. It will start the React project for you, but let me write here. Okay, it's working fine. So let me show you that it's create another. Okay, let's create h1 tag here. Hello, light. Hello. Let's save it. Now let's open your hello from Simplilearn. So it's working fine. Let's just delete this part here. Now we are going to start with our first component, which is header. Inside this component, we'll create an part header dot js. Okay, let's create another folder. Let this components folder. Let's create another folder. Let's name it styles. Here we'll add all our CSS or SCSS files. So let's enter. Inside this, let's create a file header.scss. So I'm writing SCSS because I'm using this file syntax. You can also use CSS syntax also. So let's move forward with header.js. React. Okay. Now let's write const header. Okay. Let me check the thing. Add a function which will run and return the parse of dev. Create a dev here to make it look. Most important part again is to export this file. Don't export these files, it will not run. So exporting file is very important. Let's save it. Now let's import our CSS file, which is header.scss. Oh, got to add these. Styles, inside the styles, it's header.css. Yeah, let's save it now. Okay, fine. Let's open this. Let's give the universal styling here first. So by writing star, it means it implements on everything. So we'll give margin of 0, top, or let's first padding 0, box sizing for the box. Let's save it into the add the pictures. So I'm giving every let's save it. Okay, we'll find. Let's work on this. Open your Purdue-Assist. Let's save it. Let's go to index.js. Here, as we have installed React on, so we'll write React. Okay. Browser. Route. From. As let's make use of router. Router. Let's delete this. Let's write router. Okay, this routes will write. Inside there. Save it. Let's see. Can't fetch the document part. Let's see and find the issue. Okay. Yeah. Let's save it now. It's working fine now. Okay. Node.js is defined as but never used. Okay. Yeah. Here we'll start later. But let's fix this part also. Let's give it a let's add the home component. Let's add the home component right here, the element. Save it now. Let's fix this issue. Route is not closed. Okay, it's working fine now. Yes. Now everything looks fine to me. Let's close this and let's work on the header component. Inside this header, let me just do this here. Okay, yeah, everything's looking good now. After the header part, let's create another div class logo header. By the end of this tutorial, you'll love the output of this program. So just be with me and you'll see an awesome portfolio for you guys that you can use in your colleges, or if you are a professional, the CV app will be a boom for you guys. So we are creating the header part. So inside the header, what should be the positions that we are going to use here? So I'm going to add home, about, portfolio, pages, blogs, contact. These are the things that in a basic portfolio are mandatory. So we are going to use that only. So in this H1, I'm going to write my name, Let's save it. Well, let's try it here. Let's save it. After that, I'm going to create another dev. Okay, not dev. Navbar. Inside this navbar, let's create an ordered list. Inside this, now let's create a dev of container, or let's name it as closed. Closed, okay. Inside this closed, I'm gonna use the function close class name as, let's name this as close. Let's close this. Let's see. I think fine. Okay. Okay. Now let's. Okay. Let's just not do like this. Let's just close inside the header app.js. Inside this, let's add header. Let's import our header. Let's save it. Let's import manually here. Header from header component. Let's save it. So let's see now. Let's save the, okay, the close. We haven't imported this. Let's import this. Okay, let's save it now and let's see, everything looks fine. Okay, it's not working. It's taking time to install. Let's just move forward. After this, inside this ordered list, we'll create a live component. Inside this, we'll write link. Let's save it now again. Let's import this one also. Import link. Router DOM that we have installed. React router DOM. Let's just save it. Okay, it's working fine now. Simply now. X. Okay, fine. It's started to look good. We have to add things here now. Inside this link part, let's the link here. So and inside that, let's write first part home. Okay, it's fine. Let's copy this component and reuse this 3, 4, 5 here. We'll write the home about portfolio right, blocks, and then contact page. Let's just save it. It is successfully compiled. So these are the things that we have added. Now the next step is, let's add the after this new file, create a div. Inside the div, let's name it change. Let's add the DDUI icon here of menu outlined. Yeah, inside this let's give it a class name menu. Okay, let's close this. Okay, let's save it and exporting is done. It's already been added. Now you can see the feature of React. This is where you use the Material UI icon, menu, book, outline, and automatically it's been called inside this. Let's now just run this and see. This is the icon that we needed. Okay, fine. Isn't it looking cool right now only? Okay. Let's work on the header.css or SCSS. You can use whatever function that you like. Now, the first thing I'm going to set this header and give it on vector. %. Display, let's make the display flex only because it should come on horizontally. So align item center, you can change the position. Let's write position absolute, z index 1. Okay, let's now edit. Second thing is header, after that header logo. Okay, fine. Header, inside this header logo we'll give it a margin of, I guess, it's fine for that. Let's see. Okay, Simplilearn logo we don't need like this. We will make this like, make the Simplilearn logo here. After that we'll make home, about, portfolio, blog and contact here. So let's move forward with the code. New bar. Then 0 and auto. We are making this profile as responsive, so that's why we have used. So I have also used UL ordered list. So let me display flex and let's insert this only. We call for li. Let's give it a line style of none. So next we'll give it a margin 1 rem. After that it looks good. Yeah. Now after the li we have used, okay, fine, let's make it as, 1 second, check. So let's try it. Text. So one thing I forgot to tell you, that if you're using like CSS, here I'm using SCSS. If you're using CSS, you can just write after this UL tag, audit list, then you can use like this UL LI, and inside that you can write, or you can just write LI, and inside that these commands. You don't need to write these inside the audit list only. Okay. Now let's add the text decoration. Let me give you an introduction. Give me a couple of minutes to add it. Yeah. Let's see. Define. Let's write text decoration one. That text transformation, let's write transform, uppercase, color of this word is white only. Let's add this. After that, what does it? It's not. Let's add it to part line. There. Let's add dot changer. After this, let's just open this like this. Changer. Let's make the display flex. After that, let's give it a margin of right of like 1.5 would be enough. Dot, let's write min, which was inside this, I guess. Yeah. So in CSS, if this was the case, like this, we have created here like another class of menu. In that, we have written, we have to write all the elements. Okay. But we are using this as CSS. So inside this, this is the syntax that they follow. Okay. Let's write cursor, pointer, margin of right, yeah, one is enough. You'll also get the source code of this in the description box. You can check it out. Okay, it'll be helpful for you. Just follow me throughout this video. And in the end, you'll see an amazing portfolio for you guys. Okay? Right. Closed. Okay. Close. Portfolios are really amazing for like freshers to get a job. Because in these kind of projects, you learn so many new things. Okay. So let's just save it. Okay. These are pointers. Yeah. Everything's look good. We have to give like more space here. If that did this, then let's write. Okay. Things look good. Let's see. It looks fine. Let's add the hover effects. So the hover effects will be created in this anchor tag only, but let me just get it for you guys. So it will be more clearer for you guys. Let me just add the bold tag everywhere. Let me just copy this tag. Okay. Fine. You will see it be very bold. Now let's save it. It's working fine now. Okay. Inside this anchor tag only. And that should be fit by and the keyword name hover. Inside this, let's give it the border button. 3 pixels would be fine, solid in color, and the red is my color. Let's save it and see what's the effect. Okay, as you can see, it's looking beautiful, right? Just be with me throughout this tutorial and you will love the results. Okay, so let's just make this clean. Code should always look clean. Okay, if it looks clean, it can be read properly. Anyone can read it properly. So after this close, we are gonna go with our code. I don't know why this cross is still looking. Let's read this close. I have written the function name, but let's see, it's not fetching it right, I guess. No issues. I'll do that for you guys. Okay, let's see what's the issue here. Go to another file. Close. Close. Okay. Good. Let's see the issue. Clear the code and close. It's fetching right. Let's find out. Is this cross is still here? Let's open the code. Let's make this. Insert this. Now let's save it. Okay, fine. The cross is clean. And we have fuel. See you with inspect. This function is on the page. So it will be like this. Tablet mode. Okay, fine, everything's. It's not coming right. Let's make this. Okay. We need to work on this part also. Let's see where the issue is coming. Okay, fine, we have to still work on it. It's right here. Let's write this code again. Let's just save this file. No. After that, going after the return, let's write comma like const active and make our app with active. So react question. So we'll close this bracket. It's looking, it's showing error now, but state hooks function false. Let's write a function now, const show new. Inside this, let's give it a better function, and inside this step always active. This will do is strictly active. This is the meaning of this. Let's save it and see the changes. It's showing active is not defined. Okay, active is not defined really. It's not active. It's one error is still coming. Okay, fine. Yeah, two. We have updates. Okay, fine. Everything will look good. Let's see what's the issue here. Const show menu. Show menu. It's not together. That's fine. Maybe it's showing error. Oh yeah. Now it's fine. Compile with warning. What's the issue now? Let's see, because finding errors and resolving them is very important for a developer. Increase your knowledge into the specific language you're working on. So whenever you get any difficulties in your code, just take help from someone, Google it, and you'll find the answer, I'm sure. Okay, let's find out. Show menu is assigned value but never used. Okay, let us use the show menu here. Okay, fine. Let's use the show menu inside this. Close. One click inside this. Show menu. Okay, fine. Save it. Let's see the output. Now let's inspect it. Fine here. Is okay. The tools filter list load source map cloud node load contain. Okay, it's for us. Let's make this as center. It's not in center. Let's center only. Logo, okay. List, no? Yeah. Flex margin inside between them is one, is fine. The margin is fine. Let's make it 1.2 here. In between them is 1.2, okay, fine. It's now the border box 3% solid. Okay. Let's first change this part. Right on click, and then we click on this. It will ask menu. Okay. And save it, it's compiled successfully. Space it between them, but we can already do that. Let's just, this is working fine. Let's here write a function. Save this. Let's write. Let's just complete this CSS file now, because it should be completed by now. Let's write media and set this max height. Max height would be fine. Max width we need. Okay. Give them max width 100 pixels only. We can increase it. Okay. Header. Justify content. Space. Between. Play flex on here. It should run inside that function. Okay, fine. Understood. Transition is important. Second with ease. Okay. Now bar is done. Now bar active is also important. It should respond with some actions. So we'll write display flex. It's time that flex direction should be column, not row. Whenever we go into mobile apps and all, it should be. These are the little things that you should understand while implementing any project or something, but it's very tricky also. There's so many things that you have to understand. Set or instead, whatever, like fine. Background color is very important. That's right. Set this, that's right. Right. Okay. Transition is important also. Think for this second. Please. Now it's fine. Let's complete this. You will. Writing CSS is very lengthy process, but it's cool also. We'll learn so many new things by implementing. Okay. Let's give it a mesh RAM. Okay. Fine. Now let's see LI. So let's give it a margin. Let's do DRAM. So that, let's just open another one. We'll end it. Let's make it more clean here. Let's think a tag. We'll write font size, which is 20 pixels. color which is black but not like, okay, let's find black only. 8 bolder, let's save it. See, now let's inspect. Now as you can see, the mobile version of this is like this. Isn't it cool? Okay. Everything look cool and responsive. Coming back to our code. Let's complete this one. That is done. This is done. Let's work on the changes here. Changer. Yeah. Inside this changer, we'll write. Okay, let's write menu display fine. Now we'll like close down and close. Okay. And display block. After this one, yeah. Margin left point. After this, let's write another medium. Okay, inside this, to do all these changes, let's just copy this from here. Okay, let's just write here. Max. Pixels. Now it's counting from here to here only, so 1 and here we have to copy this. Let's copy from here. Okay. Let's just paste it inside this. Everything look cool. The next thing we're going to do is like create another one. Changer inside this dot menu. Inside this display not inline block. Margin right 0. Let's save it and let's see the header now. Isn't it looking perfect? Yes. Going forward, I've increased the margin from here to 1 or 2 to 25 rem. So now it will look like this. Okay. Now we'll work on this main part. For that, let's cut this part. Okay, let's here add a new file called .scss. CSS, you can write just CSS. Okay. Inside this component part, we're gonna write another file inside this. Let's name it as main.js. Okay. Now we have created two files here. So let's open our main file. Yeah. Let's import React. Yeah. After that, let's write const basic function of React. It's just the syntax only. So this, let's return the dev empty. Let's write empty dev. Okay, it's not this, that's why it's, yeah, inside this. Now I'm gonna write, yeah, important part, exporting default. Now we'll import one in the file, CSS file of this. So we're gonna write styles, the folder path, and the file name. Save it. It'll look the same. Let's move forward with our app.js. In here we have to declare that port main from components. Yeah, let's save it. Now here we write main and let's save it. Okay. Compiled successfully. Now we'll do what? I'm going to add one folder pictures that I have created inside this, but let me just create one, a basic structure of that. Let me just open my main.js file here, and inside this main.js we have to write some code. Let's just add the assets part here. Okay. Just do this, and inside this, let's add it inside the source or like assets. Inside the source. Inside the source part, it's defined, yeah. Now I have added three pictures here to write more pictures. So let me just copy some images. Okay, in a couple of minutes. Coming back, let's make this. Inside this main, let's create another class name of main. Container. Container, let's close this. Container dev. Class name of content. Let's just close this one. Another dev of class name text, which will be used in this. Let's make it inside the beta. Hello,
21. Another. Anupav. Okay, let's create another paragraph tag. And PR symbol here to look more aesthetic. And designer. Okay, let's save it and see the output. Is it looking good? Right? Okay, so everything is lost because make it inside this header also. So let's see the are going to miss, so it's, we are missing here. It's a .js. So I have called for this one. Okay. Inside this header, after this header, let's just move here inside the header .js. Let's out. Okay, tiles are done. Let's just focus on the thing which is creating. We'll resolve it in a while. Okay, so this is done. Let's just create another div inside this class name to add the icons. So let's make this class name as icons only. It will be helpful for us only to write all the CSS properties for this. So I'm gonna add the CSS directly. So it'll save your time. We'll find the code in the description also. And I'm going to show the code here also, so you, if you want, you can just copy it. Okay, let's write Facebook. The class name of Facebook is also on. And let's, okay, it's not that. Let's copy this from now. After Facebook will be linked. Okay, fine. Okay, we haven't called it yet. It's been material UI icons, so yeah, let's call them Instagram, Facebook, Facebook. Then just write, it's not called up here, so that's why. Okay, and now it's the LinkedIn which is left. So now save it and you'll find all the logos here. Isn't it looking amazing? Right? Okay. I'm sure you're loving it now. Here, we'll add the picture. So for that, I'm going to add First, let's just complete this part only. Let's add in here for like hire me. So whenever anyone will click on that hire me button, the CV will automatically gets loaded. Okay, let's just work on that part. Let's create another dev class. And if you guys find any difficulties, you can just comment it down. I'll be happy to help in any you guys want in this front end development. I'm going to help you guys. Oh, just talking in there. H-I-R-E-E. That'll be fun. Okay, let's just close this bracket now. This, let's create another dev class. Class name, buttons. Well, let's just add one more here. Button. That's right. That's right. Connect on with me. That's right. That. Oh, contact one we are going to write in that folder. So let's write. See. That's right. Okay, let's save it. Inside this buttons, I'm going to clean links. Okay, now buttons is fine. Let's just delete it. That. Let's look. Save it. See the output. Oh, fine. I'm loving it. Let's just move forward. Okay. See, you have me inside this. Let's add a div class name. Inside this class name, we'll write name. Inside this, we're going to add the image source. That's right. You. Okay. Error and is not defined. Okay, we'll define it in a while. I'll just complete the process to define this part also. So we're going to import a new assets. The spelling of that folder was ASSEDS. In the file name that we are, let's write the proper address. Let's write profile .jpeg. Let's save it. Oh, it's coming very big. Let's add different picture here. Let's write. Yeah, no, it would work. Actually, let's save it. It's coming fine. Make it here also, but let's save it. Everything's looking perfect now. We'll make it here, like here. It'll be fine. Okay. I have already added the CSS part. You can just see here. Okay. It was same that I have showed you earlier. Just a few new things already. I'll tell you if I have added anything. Well, all look good. Okay. Nothing will look good on you. But the buttons is right. The image is here, so I'm gonna give it. It's 7. There's some line is coming in the down, so that's why I'm doing this. Little up. Is here, so it's taking this part only, so it's right for us to just not intervene in this part. Okay, this is looking good, clean and good. Let's move forward. Okay, let's move forward and create part here in this component file called section JS. Okay, inside this section.js, and let's just now only create a new file called that. Let me just write. Okay. Dot.js. Let's save it. Okay, we have written. So we have to work on these two files also. But let's just start from here. I've also added these files in an order. So let me show you guys first here. I've added these files like contacts comes in the second. Okay, let's just cut it from here. First the header will come, main page, section, and then the contact. Like this is layer, right? Save it, cut it, we don't need this. Header file is done, main file is also done, in the section and contact. Let's start with the section part. Okay, let's complete this by just writing import React okay. Let's write styles section.css. Yeah, looks cool. Now we are going to import for one more feature, which is, let's write a node 2 assets. And inside that, it will be, let's see the picture here. It let's add this picture. Yeah. Profile. PG. I have to call this inside this function that we're going to write. First, let's write. Let's cut it. Const section. Inside this section, we are going to create a function, add arrow function. Set this return. And export. The basic structure is. Basic structure is ready. Okay, let's just write something. Let's see, it's okay. Okay, let's just add these commands here so that we can see if it's working or not. Let's write class name. Let's write the class name section only. Write the sections. Let's create another div. Class name. Sections. Container. To that. Div. Class name, section, section, image. Okay, yeah, fine. Now we're going to add the image with the source. What was the source? To alter this image empty, then let's close this. Okay, let me just see here. This thing. Okay. Yeah. Okay, fine. We are working on this part. Let's see. Okay. Yes, let's write the index function now. That, yeah, we need to go. But let's just work on this part first, then also we can switch to contact page and we'll complete this part, then we'll do that. Okay, for now let's work on this section part only. After this section part, let's now add. Okay, fine. Let's create div class name section, the content that we are going to see. After that, h1. This, I'm going to write my name, a little description about me. Okay, write experience. After that, set this only. Let's write some stuff like JavaScript development. I like this only. So we'll copy it from here. Yeah. Then you can write anything of your choice about yourself. I'm gonna write Java. Python. I'm also into project management and exam, but it's like profesh UI and UX designer. Okay, let's just save it. Moving forward, everything looks fine for this. Save it. Yeah. Okay. With one warning, let's see the issue. State is defined but never used. Let's find out. Now that we have completed the rest of the part, let's complete the last part, which is contact.js part. In this, let's create the import React from React. Now, let's import the CSS file here. Let's try command.styles. Inside the styles part, it's my CSS which I have created just now. After that, let's not add anything else. It's fine for now. Okay, let's create the functions, fat arrow function. Now create, return, div, export, default, contact. Yeah, everything's look now. Looks cool. Yeah. Now let's start with the class name contact. Let's say contact. You'll love the result in the end, I'm sure. Link to, just to link the app, I'm going to add the empty file path, so it'll get linked in the arrow back class name of arrow. Let's just close this. Okay, everything looks fine. Okay, yeah, that's the reason here. Yeah, but still we have to import this link from React router down. Link from React router down. Let's save it now. Okay, yeah, we have to import the arrow back from material UI. Arrow back from at icons. Let's save it. Okay, fine. Everything's look good now. Okay. Yeah, just create another div which class name inputs, where the user will input their detail, or if anyone wants to send a message or something, inputs. After that, I'm going to create one h1 which will be the head of contact me Okay. After that, I'm going to create input types, which is input type, which is text, and the placeholder with will come inside that with name. Let's close this and let's copy this few times. Copy, paste. Okay. The second thing that a user wants is email, and the third thing that I want is the message that they want to send or something. And the class name is messages, because this box gonna be the big one. No, the name one is like the row type, email one is also the same, but the message box should be big. That's why I have written here the class name. So I'll go and edit it inside my CSS file. Inside this, let's create a button of send. Let's save it. Now I'm going to open my contact CSS file to add some CSS. Contact, let's give it a width of like 100%, height of 100%, then the background color should be white. White would be fine. After that, let's write a tag inside that the color be gray would be fine. Yeah, text decoration we don't need, so we're gonna write none dot input that we just taken. That was inputs, right? So let's write here width of 60%, height of 80%, margin of 0 and auto, and then display should be X. Flex direction because of column, and alignment item should be center, and then justify content center. Yeah, now what we will work on the H1 tag, right? H1 inside this, let's give it a color. I have noted down the color. Let's write it RGB 82, 76 dark red color. Okay, let's work on the input tag now. Let's give it a width. Center padding should be 20 pixels. Outline and the border should be also. Let's work on the last few steps of this application. Message, padding, bottom, 10 rem. After that, let's work on the bottom part. Padding will give of 10 pixels and 40 pixels. Background color, or just background only. Cursor always pointer. Chin. Top. Border of 1 pixel solid. We have to declare the color also, so we're gonna give it a color blue. Yeah, okay. Now color is defined. No, it's not defined, so let's give it a pink. But let's give it a little darker. Yeah, this is fine. Text. Uppercase. Let's forward. Add media. Max height. Max width will start with 550. Pixels. Inputs. Inside this input, I'm gonna take width of 5, and then the input size would be padding, and then 15 pixels. Let's save it. And okay, fine. Inside the app.jss, let's see, we have declared the contact page. Yeah. Let's save everything. Now it's successfully compiled. So this is the final step of our application. So these are the header part, main part that we have created here. So you can see the hover effect. Isn't it looking nice? No, you can just write a mail, email ID, message, and just send it. Isn't it looking amazing? You can always improvise the projects we have created. So you can also improvise this. So with this, we have reached the end of this video. Make sure to like and share it. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more from Simply Learn. Thank you.
Hi there, if you like this video, subscribe to the Simply Learn YouTube channel and click here to watch similar videos. To nerd up and get certified, click here.